people I don't even know. And obviously, they're going to treat you badly because of look what they've done to Haman. They have done this to Haman. Just wrong. Wrong, wrong, wrong. And yes, that was a little bit of a heel turn right there for Michael J. Burgess. Our next segment, Bray Wyatt. Video is shown. Now, before I talk about this video, I'm going to say I am very disappointed that I haven't seen the Wyatt family 2 weeks in a row. They have only shown videos. Why? I'm getting sick of it. I want to see the Wyatts. We all want to see the Wyatt family. They're demented. Hell yes. We're just learning more about them, but they have to show up to Monday Night Raw. They have to show up. Anyway, in this video, Bray Wyatt says that Icarus was warned never to get too close to the sun. Pride can even make the most noble men do foolish things. As Icarus neared the sun, his wings began to melt, and Icarus fell into the ocean and was never heard from again. Where is Cain? Wyatt says that he warned Cain and said that the fire that he thought was his friend would be his ending. When Cain allowed his pride to cloud his common sense, he knew that Cain was his, like a lamb that was led to slaughter. Bray wonders where his monster has gone. Cain has made his bed, and now he is burning in it. Very good promo. Very good video by the Wyatts. Hell of a job, A+, without a doubt. Now, Cody Rhodes versus Randy Orton is up next. This was a pretty good match, obviously. I'm just going to cut right down to the chase. The winner of this match Randy Orton. Without a doubt, Randy Orton. You know, sadly, Triple H fired Cody Rhodes right there on the spot. We probably won't see Cody Rhodes for at least 3 weeks. You know, this firing, it's just fitting into a storyline. And obviously, yes, WWE did move his profile to the WWE alumni page. But he is still in contract with the WWE. Next, CM Punk comes out and promises no more empty threats or posturing and no more talking because he is tired of all this crap that Heyman is talking about and all these things. He wants Heyman and he wants him now. You know, to be honest with you, I want to ask everyone a question because is Night of Champions a paper? I thought Night of Champions was a pay-per-view where, I mean, every title was on the line, but my question is, why is Curtis Axel's title not on the line? And that really kind of worries me, because I don't know what to say. What is WWE thinking here? Every title's supposed to be on the line at Night of Champions, and yet it's not. So I don't know what the hell WWE is thinking here, but they really should fix it. Well, moving on. We get a backstage segment, and you know, it's Daniel Bryan and the Big Show in the locker room. And Big Show says that he didn't want to fight Daniel Bryan tonight. Very emotional Big Show, still crying. And you know, Bryan says in the end that he will beat Show just like he did for his first World Heavyweight Championship. Up next, we got our Divas action. This, if I'm sure, only lasted about 30 seconds. AJ came on commentary. Yes, the beautiful AJ. Match ended in no contest, and this did set up a fatal four-way match at Night of Champions for the Divas Championship. And if I'm not mistaken, it is Natalya versus Naomi versus Brie Bella versus AJ for the Divas Championship. Then we get RVD versus Damian Sandow. This one, without a doubt, RVD's going to win. And as you know, WWE likes to bury their Mr. Money in the Bank winners, unless you're Randy Orton. But, nonetheless, RVD won. Next, we get our main event, Big Show versus Daniel Bryan. You know, Show pleaded with Bryan not to do this match, but Bryan just starts unloading and kicks Big Show with a series of drop kicks in the corner. Show enters with a series of chops to Bryan, slammed by Show. Bryan comes up at Show again, and Show with a headbutt and body shot, backsplash by Show, and Bryan with a drop kick floors Show. Show with the spear sets up for the KO, but he just leaves the ring. Triple H then comes out with the Shield. Triple H orders Show to get back in the ring and finish it. The Shield run in and attack Bryan. Show gets back in, and Triple H tells him to think about his family and orders him to step back. The Shield deliver the triple powerbomb to Bryan, and Show is forced to watch. Show crying the entire time. Big ass crybaby. But Triple H orders him to knock out Bryan. But Show says no and tells Triple H to leave him alone. Stephanie walks out. Stephanie tells Show to think about his family and says it's his last chance. Show reluctantly knocks him out, and Triple H says Show did the right thing. Randy Orton then walks out and stands over Bryan to end Monday Night Raw in Des Moines, Iowa. Well, that was our rundown of the WWE Monday Night Raw results for September 2nd, 2013. Wow. Just wow. What did you think of Raw? What did I think of Raw is more important? I would give it a C. It's average, but I was still very disappointed in it. I was looking very forward to the main event, but it didn't end how I would have liked it to, but you know, it's still just kind of one of those average main events, you know? It's hard to compare it to TNA or Ring of Honor and all of that, but it was an average show. You know, a lot of people still go home happy with an average show, you know? It was Des Moines, Iowa. The crowd's not as strong as some of those in the United Kingdom and New York, New Jersey area. But, you know, it's still an average Raw, still worth the money, I guess. But we're going to take a quick break here, our halftime break, so to say. And coming up, we've got three top stories coming your way. And we've got some special announcements going to go live down right here on the Ringside Podcast. And of course, the future of WorldWrestlingNews.com is at stake. And of course, so is the future of the Ringside Podcast is up for stake as well. But tune in next, right here, live.
The best, you can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You could beat the world, you could beat the war, you could talk the guy, go banging on his door.
You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock, yeah. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks.
You could be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you go find yourself.
Standing in the Hall of Fame,
yeah.
And the world.
You can run the mile. You can walk straight through hell with a smile. You could be the hero. You could get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought never could be broke.
Yeah, do it for your people. Do it for your pride. You're never gonna know if you never even try.
Do it for
for your country, do it for your name, cause there's gonna be a day when you're
standing in the hall of fame,
yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name,
yeah.
Cause you burn with the brass flame,
yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name,
yeah.
And you'll be on the walls of the
politicians, be preachers,
yeah.
Be believers, be leaders, be astronauts, be champions, be truth seekers, be students, be teachers, be politicians, be preachers,
yeah.
Be believers, be leaders, be astronauts, be champions.
Welcome back to the Ringside Podcast. Obviously, I'm Michael Burgess, the host and owner of WorldWrestlingNews.com, and we've got some special announcements coming on down right now. So if you can, go to your search engine right now and type WorldWrestlingNews.com. And first of all, I want everyone to just take a look at the tabs. These are brand new tabs. First of all, we have a tab called Home. Without a doubt, I'm sure most of you know by now that you click on that, takes it to our homepage, does it not? And, of course, if you go to, right over to it, that is called our interactive page. And of course, that interactive page, obviously, is our live coverage. And first of all, this interactive page it's a little bit different. It's changing very, very often. We're just trying to update it more and more, because this is probably the most important page on our entire website. This is where a lot of our advertisements come in at. A lot of writers are made professionals right here. Without a doubt, I'm happy to announce live on this episode of the Ringside Podcast that as of September 3rd, 2013, WorldWrestlingNews.com is happy to bring a free premium live coverage on interactive two nights a week for Raw and SmackDown, and one night a month for a WWE pay-per-view. Yes, that deserves a standing ovation indeed. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Of course, this is something new. We used to have a premium account. We used to have premium members. We actually had about 300 of them. 300 premium members. And of course, about a week or two ago, I think it was about 2 weeks ago, we went